If I knew what I know now 8 years ago, it would save me so much time and energy. Hi, my name is Rene and welcome to Self-Made Coders. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you 7 lessons that I personally wish I knew when I started as a self-taught developer. The lesson number 1 is that don't copy-paste the code. I can't stress this enough. If you have just started to learn coding, type the code yourself. It makes a huge difference. On the surface, it might not look that important. You find a piece of code on Stack Overflow or maybe from a demo project of the programming course that you're taking. You copy the code and paste it in your own project, everything works, and you're happy. But here's the thing, when you're just starting out, you're not comfortable with typing code. And the way you can be more comfortable with it is by typing more code. The other reason is when you type the code yourself, it puts you on the learning mindset. Your brain would pay more attention to the piece of code that you are writing and tries to understand it. On the other hand, when you copy-paste code, your brain would think that this piece of information is not that important and it would pay less attention to it. The second lesson is to send your resume before you feel ready. This is one of the worst mistakes I made in my early career. I waited too long to send my resume. I always had some excuse like, I'm not ready yet. I don't know this type of information. If I go to interviews and they ask me questions, I might not be able to answer them and it would be embarrassing. And as a result, I spent the time working on things and concepts that I really didn't need to spend time on. For example, as an iOS developer, I spent the time learning AR and machine learning. Even though it was fun to work on the projects like this, the company that I wanted to work for didn't have any intention to see portfolios like this on my resume. They were more interested to see if I could solve problems and I have a deep understanding of software architecture. But here's a tip, let the market decide if you're ready or not. Send your resume and get the feedback. And also keep this in mind, when you're sending your resume, especially when you're in your early career, you're gonna get rejected a lot. Maybe 8 of those companies would reject your resume and 2 of them would ask you on the interview. Go to those interviews. Don't expect to get the job. Just focus on learning and get the feedback on your resume so you can improve it. The lesson number 3. Soft skills are as important as technical skills. It doesn't matter how good of a coder you are if you can't present yourself. You need to learn how to write a good resume, showcase your portfolio, and learn how to connect with others and communicate. Doing an interview is a skill too. You need to learn how to respond to the questions that you're not able to find an answer. If the interviewer asks you a question and you don't know the answer, what are you going to do? Are you going to answer them with something that you don't know is true or not? Are you going to be honest with them and tell them that you don't know the answer? These are soft skills that you need to spend more time on. In the later videos, I'm gonna go deep into how to build your resume as a developer when you don't have any experience. And I'm also gonna talk a lot about soft skills that you need to learn as a developer. The lesson number 4, build your own app or website. You need to have experience in order to land a job, and you need a job to gain experience. But how can you gain experience without having the job? Build your own apps or website. If you're a mobile developer, build applications and publish them on App Store for iOS developers and Google Play for Android developers. If you're a front-end developer or a full-stack developer, build a website and showcase your skills. But how would a back-end developer showcase his work? Easy. The answer is GitHub. Build open source projects and don't forget to write the README file. Explain what technologies you have used, what challenges you have, and how you solve them. By the way, are you working on your app or website right now? Comment coders down below and tell me more about it. Lesson number 5. High salary versus high learning opportunity. This is another mistake I made in my early career. As a mid-level iOS developer, I accepted a job in a company that had a really good payment, but there was no learning opportunity. There were no senior developers in those companies so I can learn from. And as a result, I was struggling so much and I was under lots of pressure. So if you have a job offer and you're wondering which one you should choose, choose the one that has the most learning opportunity for you. Are there senior developers in those companies? Are they willing to teach you? Are you going to be the solo developer of the company? These are the things that you need to consider before accepting a job. And the final lesson is to learn how to ask better questions. If you want the right answers, you need to ask the right questions. So many times in my early career, I couldn't find the answer to my question, not because the answer didn't exist on the internet, but because I was not asking the right questions. Learn how to ask better questions. And learn how to use Google search on its full potential. By the way, I share bite-sized information on my Instagram account, so make sure to check that out as well. That's it for this video. If you liked it, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more.